The moments of non-f***ery are the moments that most define our lives. The major switch in careers, the spontaneous choice to drop out of college and join a rock band, the decision to finally dump that deadbeat boyfriend whom you caught wearing your pantyhose a few too many times. To not give a f*** is to stare down life's most terrifying and difficult challenges and still take action. Wow. I love this book. Also, I love the guy who wrote this book because right now I'm in his bathtub and this is going to be the greatest property tour you've ever seen. And I just don't give a f***. Before we get started, I just want to point out a few things. We're about to put this apartment on the market like tomorrow. We've got an active photo shoot going on right over there, going through. We're finishing staging. This art's really, really cool. And typically I'd want to do a tour like this of a $13 million apartment that's 54, 57 square feet, 5 bedrooms, 5.5 bathrooms, quiet. I'd want it to be perfect. But guess what? I just don't give a. So welcome to the great room. How huge this space is, all this natural light coming in south. Right now we are in penthouse D of 11 Beach Street in the heart of Tribeca. You've got Fashion Week that happens right there. I can see it through the window. You've got the Tribeca Film Festival that happens right there. I can see it through the same window. You've got the best schools, the best restaurants. Robert De Niro just walked by me right over there, or at least a guy that looked like Robert De Niro because he could be there. Everything in Tribeca happens right here, and this apartment is brand new. It's almost 6,000 square feet. There's more bedrooms than I actually have time to show you. It's barely been lived in. It's expertly designed. It is gorgeous, and I cannot wait for you to see it. Open living space, dining, living room. Bedroom number 6, if you want it to be, is this really, really cool den. And let me show you this. So you can actually take this door. It is solid core. It is massive. It's like one of the biggest pocket doors ever. And you can totally close it off. And then you've got an enclosed 6-bedroom, guest room, den, home office, movie theater, the way this is set up. I love what's been done to the walls. I love plaster. I don't like plaster everywhere because it can be really overwhelming and it's almost like you tried too hard with your interior designer. But I love it in specific moments like this where it really defines the room and creates the character. Audio-visual system is incredible. Bathroom, closet space, it's really, really awesome. Now you saw the living and dining space, you've seen the den. Wait till you see how big this kitchen is. Maybe one of the largest kitchens and eating kitchens that you'll see in New York City, with the exception of townhouses, but this is a penthouse. You've got 2 sinks, top of the line appliances. These are 2 of the biggest refrigerators I've ever seen. There's like nothing in here whatsoever. 4 different freezer drawers. You've got 2 ovens, 2 microwaves, huge wine cooler. Like I said, you already got the 2 sinks. You've got the multiple Miele cooktop. You can cook whatever you want. Everything vents out. This is a big, beautiful pantry. Actually, take a look at this. Talk about organization, okay? Some people don't give a about organization, but some people do. Wow. Now I know where my almonds are. Also my walnuts. Also everything else, possibly. That is a beautiful sight. All the OCD in me just went away. And the leather finish on this marble, I know you can't feel it, but maybe there's like a way to do a little like ASMR. Come close. Come close. Can you feel this? I love this eat-in space. You can do so much here, whether it's bookshelves or just extra storage for pots, for pans, for plates, and everything else. And then you've got a windowed kitchen. Typically, as an interior window, you'd say, the interior of the building. But the facade is such a unique paneling system with all the different bow ties, and you'll see it. It's just really cool to look at. It's like looking at a really, really big sculpture that is secret in the center of New York City, only for these residents. Really, really cool. Now this apartment, like I said, has 5 full bedrooms, 5.5 bathrooms. You haven't even seen any of them, so let's get started. At the south side of the apartment, starting right here, we have the entire primary suite. It's the size of most two-bedroom apartments. We've got two full bathrooms, plus a sauna, which I'm gonna show you, two walk-in closets, more storage space than you're ever gonna need. You've got a full wet bar, sink, refrigerator, tons of storage space. I love the stone, how it wraps all the way around. This is called framing. I think it's really, really pretty. It's very tasteful. Like I said, we're taking photos. This is Rich Kaplan, our photographer, Sean Jadidian, say hello. Walk-through closet for her, it's totally mirrored, so it's gonna be hard to show you that. And then this is where we started, in the tub, reading one of the greatest books of all time, and I love this bathroom. I love this stone. You've got a makeup counter here, a beautiful vanity, gorgeous lighting. You've got a full steam shower, a separate water closet, and these huge views. I got 56 Leonard, Woolworth, 30 Park Place. I'm looking down to World Trade. I've got one World Trade, 111 Mur. I mean, I've got everything here. And you could actually sit in the tub and get a suntan. Name one other interior apartment where the bathroom, you can sit in the tub with total privacy and you can get some sun. I'm waiting. I can't hear you, but you can leave it in the comments. This time, instead of punching you, let's say I buy you a house. Yes, reader, I just bought you a house. I'm not gonna read you the whole book. This is another great book written by the same guy. Bedroom number three is this amazing home office. Now, this is a huge bedroom, and you could have 10 kids in this room. You could do bunk beds here, bunk beds here. You could do two full beds, you could do a queen bed. The bedrooms in this apartment are massive. They have amazing closet space and gorgeous ensuite baths that have also never been used. So we've got the first guest room, we've got this office. Now I'm gonna show you the next guest room. And this is where it all happens. This is one of my favorite rooms in all of New York. The minute I walked in here, I just felt smarter. I think that's what the feeling was. And I just love it. It's a great bedroom, amazing closet space, amazing ensuite, gorgeous marble bathroom. Great windows, incredible light, but it's also set up like one of the coolest work from home spaces I've ever seen. It's all set up for absolutely everything. You are good to go from here. Again, an easy bedroom. We've got another guest bedroom at the end of the hallway, plus a whole separate laundry room too. And to cap it all off, 11 Beach has some of the greatest amenities you'll find in a full service building in Tribeca. 24-hour doorman and concierge, bespoke gym that's set up for yourself, private trainers, or just to get a great workout in. And you've got this incredible landscaped roof deck. I can go for like a nature walk around this whole thing. And you've got this amazing view down into the very special and curated terracotta facade. Interiors of the building are done by Thomas Jewel Hansen, one of my favorites. And that is the tour. That is Penthouse D at 11 Beach, now on the market with Serhant's signature. Thank you so much for watching.